the sanctified life, lust that war against the soul. Wherever they may be, those who are truly sanctified will elevate the moral standard by preserving correct physical habits and, like Daniel, presenting to others an example of temperance and self-denial. Every depraved appetite becomes a warring lust. Everything that conflicts with natural law creates a diseased condition of the soul. The indulgence of appetite produces a dyspeptic stomach, a torpid liver, a clouded brain, and thus perverts the temper and spirit of the man. And these enfeebled powers are offered to God, who refused to accept the victims for sacrifice unless they are without a blemish. It is our duty to bring our appetites and our habits of life into conformity to natural law. If the bodies offered upon Christ's altar were examined with the close scrutiny to which the Jewish sacrifices were subjected, who would be accepted? With what care should Christians regulate their habits that they may preserve the full vigor of every faculty to give to the service of Christ? If we would be sanctified in soul, body, and spirit, we must live in conformity to the divine law. The heart cannot preserve consecration to God while the appetites and passions are indulged at the expense of health and life. Those who violate the laws upon which health depends must suffer the penalty. They have so limited their abilities in every sense that they cannot properly discharge their duties to their fellow men, and they utterly fail to answer the claims of God. When Lord Palmerston, Premier of England, was petitioned by the Scotch clergy to appoint a day of fasting and prayer to avert the cholera, he replied, in effect, "Cleanse and disinfect your streets and houses, promote cleanliness and health among the poor, and see that they are plentifully supplied with good food and raiment, and employ right sanitary measures generally, and you will have no occasion to fast and pray. Nor will the Lord hear your prayers while these, his preventives, remain unheeded." Says Paul, "Let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God." 2 Corinthians 7, verse 1. He presents for our encouragement the freedom enjoyed by the truly sanctified. "There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit." Romans 8, verse 1. He charges the Galatians, "Walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh." Galatians 5, verse 16. He names some of the forms of fleshly lust, idolatry, drunkenness, and such like. Galatians chapter 5, verses 20 and 21. And after mentioning the fruits of the Spirit, among which is temperance, he adds, "And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts." Verse 24. The Sanctified Life, chapter 3, controlling the appetites and passions.